In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful. The Quran's greatest concern is to concentrate on high goal. One who wants to achieve high goal has no option but to foster the aforementioned qualities. He has to try to effectively manage all undesirable situations, otherwise he will become preoccupied by the trivial issues and will fail to continue his journey toward high goal. Quran says in Surah Shams, the verse number 9 and 10, Qad aflaha man zakka wa qad khaba man dasa. He who purifies it will indeed be successful, and he who corrupts it is sure to fail. These Quranic verses refers to the importance of personality development, laying emphasis not on its physical but on its spiritual aspects. It is no exaggeration to say that this is the main theme of the Quran, personality development being its basic goal. Here is the question, what is purification of the soil? It is to purify your mind of all kind of bias and negativity. In other words, it is to decondition your conditioning. This is the mind the Quran tries to build. One who fails in this deconditioning process will become a corrupt or an unwanted personality in the divine scheme of things. The process of conditioning begins right from birth. Initially, it is an unconscious process. The individual's family, his institutions, his society, and his community, all are the sources of this conditioning. From childhood up to adolescence, he is affected by this conditioning. Only after reaching adulthood does he become able to understand this problem consciously. From here onwards begins what is called personality development. It calls for an awakening of the mind and a conscious discovery of this problem. At this stage, the individual must develop the capacity for anti-self thinking. He must engage in introspection. He must try to decondition his previous conditioning with all objectivity. This is the most important task for every man and woman. Here is the question, what is deconditioning? It is a process of sorting out the items you have stored in your mind, all of which you must view with all objectivity if you are to overhaul your personality in a dispassionate manner. You have to remove the negative items in your mind if you are to turn your negativity into positivity. There is a hadith in Sahih Bukhari 6116, narrated Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He said, a man once asked the Prophet of Islam a question, O Prophet, give me a masterpiece of advice by which I may be able to manage all the affairs of my life. The Prophet, peace be upon him, replied, don't be angry. This means that you must try to purify yourself of anger. Don't allow anger to become a part of your personality. It's only in this way you can truly develop your personality.